Nitish Kumar has taken a public position which is different from the position that the BJP has taken. Why is it that you believe that there needs to be a probe and a proper debate into Love Affair Pegasus? Abhishek.
So many people are complaining that their phone has been taped and their privacy has been broken. At this point of time, so our leader, Honorable Nitish Kumarji, expressed that if at all someone is believing that his privacy is being hindered or his phone is being taped, we can have a discussion on that, or we can move forward to find out if it is true or not.
IT minister was giving a statement on the floor of the parliament. Do you remember what had happened with him? A Trinamool Congress MP snatched the paper he was reading it out for the benefit of the people of this great country and the member of parliament, and they didn't allow him to speak. I mean, they disrupted the parliament. They didn't allow him to make a speech. If he had been allowed to speak, make a statement, then they could have debated about it. They could have asked him a question, but they didn't.
Various adjournment motions have been made so that this issue can be discussed. Why has not even a single one been accepted? Debate in parliament on an issue happens through adjournment motion. Why has not a single one been accepted? That's question number one. Who do we listen to? The IT minister, the same IT minister who 2 hours after he made that statement, poor man found that his number was also being snooped upon. Number three, and this is a very important point I would want to make, Rahul, this is not some phone tapping. This is not just eavesdropping conversations. This is a military-grade spyware found in phones, and 10 phones have been forensically verified that they were found. It is not in just members of opposition phones. It is in the phones of a constitutional authority, a woman associated with the Chief Justice of India, elected members of parliament, elected chief ministers. This amounts to treason.
This is a very serious issue. The Trinamool Congress and the other opposition parties, they want the presence of the Prime Minister, and the Home Minister should make a specific statement in the floor of the House, which the government is not agreeing to. It is absolutely clear that the government had purchased this particular software from the Israeli military company, because there is no specific denial on the part of the government that no, we had not purchased this military spyware.
The Congress party is the largest opposition party. Now the charge against the Congress party is you are doing these cycle rallies, all very well, getting media attention through that. But what about inside parliament? What about questioning the government on the real issues of price rise and COVID instead of disrupting parliament? The government says, these are the Prime Minister's words, this is a disgrace to parliament.
The opposition is completely united in its demands of the ruling party. You ask any spokesperson of the government, anybody who comes on your channel, they will all say, yes, we are ready to discuss. We are ready to discuss farmers. We are ready to discuss COVID. We are ready to discuss price rise. And then you ask them next question, are you ready to discuss Pegasus? And then you will be met by silence, you will be met by obfuscation, you will not get a clear
answer.
No,
but the opposition cannot decide your sequencing. Mr. Gaurav Gogoi, you are now in parliament for a decade, you know that the chair will decide which issue comes first.
That's fine, Rajdeep. I am not going to matter of sequencing. I'm saying at least put Pegasus on the list.
The government is saying that they're willing to discuss everything. Mm-hmm. Now, please show it to me in the list of business, Mr. Sardesai, where the government has put up for discussion, a discussion on COVID, economy, rising prices, or for that matter, farmers' issues, or for that matter, issues of national security and interest, which is Pegasus. Do not reduce it to just spying and surveillance. What was happening was hacking of phones, taking away all the data, including their including their photographs, videos, etc., and having access to mics and cameras of every single phone.
Everything that the BJP did when they were in the opposition, today the Congress is doing a tit for tat, taking the BJP back. Unfortunately, what you do when you do this is that you give the government a free pass. And that's the second point I want to make. You really give the government a completely free pass in parliament. From the winter session last year, now to the next winter session, the government is not going to be answerable. That's it.
Our position is very clear that when the government has said that nothing like this has happened, but still news are coming in that various countries have started investigation, parliament is being stalled for the last 2 weeks, no regular parliamentary function is happening. So my leader clearly said that if this much confusion is prevailing, what's the harm in getting the investigation done? Because if something wrong has been done, it should come out.
Right.
That is our position on it.
How bad is the situation in Pakistan if Imran Khan first had to sell off his buffaloes, then about 100 cars, of which I think only 61 were actually sold, and now Pakistan government wants to rent out his official residence?
From the beginning, Imran Khan always says that he want a simple life, and he want to show the world, or especially the Pakistanis, that he is a very simple person. So he avoid all the luxuries and everything. That's why first he said that he will make his house as a university or college, and now he make it as a for that, not the whole house, but some portion of it to use by the public as a, of course, they will rent it out for some events, fashion shows, as they told that fashion shows and food festivals, international and national level.
I believe marriage parties also, there's been a marriage party organized there. Some brigadier's children were married off there, I'm told.
Yeah, same. I also heard that.
You know, he sold off cars, but he's using helicopter. And the Minister for Information says that it is 55 rupees a kilometer, whereas each trip costs 2 to 3 lakh of rupees. And you are absolutely right. 47% of the budget goes to debt servicing. According to Al Jazeera, 25% of the budget goes for defense. So 70 to 72% of the budget goes for debt servicing and defense. And that is $30 billion. And here you're talking of 8 buffaloes. So what else can one say if not theatrics? And it is unfortunate.
There's no denying the fact that a country which has decided to bleed India with 1,000 cuts, a country that wanted to use terrorism as an instrument of state policy, a country which is absolutely bankrupt today, has an army which runs a business of $20 billion a year. And from the state, it takes about $10 billion a year to survive. It is in debt to the tune of $10 billion to China. It has almost sold out to China on every front. A country which is absolutely divided. It's surprising how Pakistan could be doing such kind of a thing, which believes in nothing but Allah, army, and Atankwad.